Good afternoon to one and all. I'm Megha Jain, third year student of Forensic Science from Dr. Harisingh Gaur University, Sagar MP, is going to present on the examination of antemortem and postmortem drowning. In drowning, death occurs due to loss of respiration. Antemortem and postmortem drowning cannot be distinguished after 24 hours. The next slide, please. Examination of drowning. When a person falls in a water body, the body of the person drowns due to gravity. But the density of water, that is 1.010, is almost equal to the density of human body, that is 1.018. As water enters the mouth, the density of the body increases. Due to buoyancy, the body comes up 2 to 3 times. After 12 to 14 hours, putrefactive changes begin. If the temperature of the water and the surrounding is different, then these changes may occur in 7 to 8 hours. Gas is produced, which is maximum in the stomach because of the hollow space. As the body's area increases, density decreases. Abdominal weight increases and the weight of lower region decreases. So the stomach is upwards and the rest of the body parts are laid back. Gas comes out of the mouth, hence body moves and eventually comes up. Even a 40 kg weight tied to the body cannot resist the body from coming up. Rigor mortis passes out after 24 hours. The next slide, please. The difference between antemortem and postmortem drowning are listed below. In antemortem drowning, the body doesn't come up quickly because putrefactive changes are slow. Body is generally upside down and the head is laid backwards. But if the depth of the water body is less, then the body may be upright. In postmortem drowning, the body comes up quickly because of lack of struggle and stoppage of the activities. In dead body, water enters mouth and then the body drowns slightly. So the body doesn't flip. The body comes up at an angle of almost 90 degrees. The next slide, please. Here's the diagrammatic representation of how drowning occurs. First, the body drowns, then it flips, and then it starts floating. The next slide. Conclusion. By studying the position of the body as it comes out of the water body and studying the putrefactive changes, it can be proved whether the death was antemortem or postmortem. In drowning cases, the cadaveric spasm, that is collection of mud during struggle, and washerman's skin, that is cutis encerine, is used in the study. Also, to mention about the diatoms test, if the diatoms are found in the respiratory tract, the death is considered to be antemortem, and if they are absent, then the death may be postmortem. But the presence of diatoms cannot be used as a concluding evidence because they are present in drinking water and can be found in the respiratory tract. They cannot be studied in the crime scene and require very precise examination in the laboratory. Lastly, I would like to mention that it is not necessary that all the mentioned evidences and conditions are found in each and every case. Each case needs to be examined individually as the evidence differ from case to case, depending on the surrounding conditions. These evidences cannot be used as a concluding evidence, but they are of great aid in providing a direction to further investigation. Lastly, I would like to wrap up by mentioning that all this study is based on an internship, which I have underwent in the Police Control Room Sagar and Forensic Science Laboratory Sagar, and all the data which I have presented was told me by the scientific officer, and from that and the case studies which I have done, I have presented this paper. Thank you.